Well, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Nate, and I want to be your next governor. Let me start off with saying I believe in the caucus system, I believe in the endorsement system, and I will honor every one of your votes at the state convention for the endorsed candidate to be your next governor. If it's me, I want to be that guy. If it's not, I will support and write a check that day to the guy who's going to be the endorsed candidate. Let's get that out of the way. Thank you. And a little about me. I'm a Minnesotan, born and bred. I was born in Glenville. For those of you who went CD7, that's McLeod County. And I went home. There they are. I went home from the hospital to my grandparents' farm, which is still in our family almost 150 years. And that's outside of Biscay, which is about 100 people and a liquor store. And that's where I learned what Minnesotans are all about. That's where I learned the values of Minnesotans, which is you get up every morning and you go to work. You don't wait for a government handout. That you have a sense of community, that you work together. As a big, strong kid, unfortunately, I'm still pretty big. I was loaned out to neighboring farms to do second cut alfalfa. You guys remember how hot that is? I was also there to clean up the farrowing crates and dairy barns, which makes me eminently qualified to know what manure is and how much His Highness Mark Date I has piled up in the governor's office. We're going to have to clean out when we get our next governor here in Minnesota, and it's a Republican. Why do I want to be your next governor? Because we need a fighter for our values. We've tried Minnesota Nice candidates and it's not working. When you get punched in the face as a candidate, you gotta come back and punch them in the gut. We have to have that attitude and be a fighter, not just turn the other cheek. Now, I'm gonna do a quick poll here. How many of you would like to see us reduce the sales tax in Minnesota from almost 7% down to 5%? Raise your hands. Okay, who doesn't? I don't see anybody. We can do it. My first proposal is your next governor will be what I call 5 for 5. We're going to reduce spending, not the rate of growth, reduce spending by 5% and reduce sales taxes to 5%. Well, what's that going to do? It's going to help every Minnesotan. Rich or poor, black or white, urban or rural, you're going to keep money in your pocket, and we can do it. If you're a single mom, and you have a couple kids at home and you make $35,000 a year, you get to keep about $500 more of your money in your pocket. If you're an average Minnesotan and you have $80,000 worth of income, you'll save almost $1,000 a year and keep it in your pocket, not the government's pocket. How can we do that? Well, let's talk about a couple of programs, at least one program we can get rid of. There's a group that we give money to called Urban Emerge. They actually had paid protesters on your tax dollar at the governor's mansion during the Philando Castillo stuff. They had paid protesters on your dollar. I think we can get rid of that program, don't you? Members love to spend your money on paid protesters. They love to spend money on sports stadiums. And then after they build the sports stadiums, then they disrespect our national anthem. They disrespect the sacrifices that our veterans have made for this country. And they have nothing but excuses for a broken United States Senator who should resign today. Look at the others that are in the race right now. Let's talk about Tim Walz, Congressional 1. Tim Walz. I don't call him Tim Walz, I call him Two-Faced Timmy. Why? We have to attack Democrats, not our other Republicans. And I call him Two-Faced Timmy because in 2008, he was proud of his NRA endorsement. In 2010, he was proud of his NRA endorsement. In 2012, he was proud of his NRA endorsement. What did he just do? He's sending all of his money from his NRA, the money he got from the NRA back, and then he hires the most gun-grabbing liberal with the thinnest resume to be his lieutenant governor candidate, Peggy Flanagan. His resume is so thin you can see through it. Minnesotans don't want flip-floppers, they want leaders. They want leaders in St. Paul for our values. There's a movement going on in St. Paul right now. We always talk about life begins at conception. There's also right to die legislation. Right to die legislation that devalues life. I have a personal story. My mother-in-law, 2.5 years ago, had an accident in a shower, of all things. And she was a quadriplegic for the last 2.5 years of her life. But she gave back to her grandchildren. They brought her their concerts on her iPads to show them. We can't devalue life in this state. We must defend it. We need a fight in the Gap Governor's Mansion. Am I electable? Absolutely. Because I stand for the values of Minnesotans, not liberals and the elitists that are in St. Paul. I stand for values that stand for your liberty. I have presented the bill to destroy the Metropolitan Council, not try and fix it, because they are nothing but a bunch of socialists appointed by the governor trying to take away your city's ability to manage itself. I also sponsored an attack light rail. We must stop light rail in Minnesota. I appreciate your time. As a 2-3-time Taxpayer League Award winner and the best friend of the taxpayer, we've got to have a new governor that will defend your wallet and life here in Minnesota. Thank you very much.